Hello and welcome to episode 2, Cooking for Morons. This week I'm going to be making a cheese sandwich. Now I used various things last week to make toast. I'm not going to go over that again. Just watch the video and then you can catch up. Right, let's begin. Now I got my gear here to cook. Now I'm going to do something new this week. This is a breadboard. Now it's not essential because you could use the work surface. But for us professional chefs, we like to use a breadboard. Right, so tell your friends, if you're talking about what you've done and made a sandwich, it's a bit high tech, but they'd be very impressed if you mention breadboard. Right, here's the bread, which we used last week. Now this week, I'm gonna be using 2 slices of bread instead of 1. It's essential in making a sandwich. Right, so you get the bread, you get the butter, which we talked about last week. Open the butter up. Get your knife, remember your knife. Butter. And caress, remember, as I said last week, caress the butter into the bread. Like so. There we go. Now that's phase one. Phase one, we can put the butter back, and there we go. Now, to make a cheese sandwich, you're obviously going to need cheese. Now, it's a yellow substance, a block, which again can be bought in all supermarkets and some corner shops. Now, this comes the tricky part. See this line here? We have to cut that with the scissors. Now, this is a scissor. If you haven't seen one of these before, you put your hands in this end. Don't try to do that. It's not going to cut. You need to do that, see? Right, you might need a little bit of help for this, so get somebody who's done this before and they can talk you through it, like so. There we go, because I'm a professional, it's a little bit easier for me. Now, you peel, well you're supposed to peel that, so I'm obviously not that much of a professional, so I've got to cut a little bit more off. Just remember, this program is called Cooking for Morons. And I can be a little bit moronic on times. There we go. I'm hoping that would be enough. If not, you might see a little bit of rage, which is normal in the cooking profession. Right. Yes, rage. So what I'm going to do now, just go a little bit mental and open it like that. I wouldn't advise that, but I'm a bit crazy sometimes. Right, there we are. Here's the cheese. Now, a common mistake in making a cheese sandwich is to do this. Cheese sandwich, pop it on there like that. Now, that is not right. That is Now, that's the sign I will be using throughout the show. It's from Family Fortunes, which is a popular quiz show in the 80s. Means no. Right, so that is no. So we pick that up. And what we have to do now is cut the cheese. Now you think this is a knife? This is a knife. You might get that joke if you watch Crocodile Dundee, a very popular film from the mid 80s. If not, and just to be clear, they are both knives. This is a long, sharper knife. See the edge? Better for cutting cheese. Right. Oh, now this is very tricky. So you might need to get somebody who's made a sandwich before, somebody in the family, or phone somebody up if you want them to come over to supervise you with this or to help. Advisable to phone them up before you decide to make the sandwich, because if you phone them up now, it may take a bit of time to come over. And you will lose your flow. Right. So let's cut the cheese. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I think 5 slices should do it. 1, 2, and place it on like so. Right. That is correct. Now that, for my correct sign, I'm going to do a big tick like that. I'm going to call it Saturday Night Fever. Now that's correct. Not eh-eh. So this, if you didn't put enough on, see, it's a bit missing. Eh-eh. But this, remember, Saturday Night Fever. Right. Now what you need to do now is always remember to put your second piece with the butter facing the cheese. Like you've got the butter facing the cheese here. Do not do that. Right, because you get butter all over your hands. It just doesn't work. It just doesn't work. That's So you do like so. Then you turn it. Now we're nearly there. We're nearly there. We're making a lot of progress here today. You can move your cheese out of the way for now. I'll do an episode on tidying up later on in the series, so you don't have to worry about that. Don't want to complicate things. Now they're almost a sandwich. Now when cutting a sandwich, you could cut it various ways. You could cut it diagonally, you could cut it down the middle, you could cut it in little squares. But again, I don't want to get ahead of myself. We just stick to the basics and cut it a regular way. So go right down the middle here. Don't do that. Don't do that, because you're going to have one big piece and one small piece. Right. Down the middle. Be very careful. Hopefully you've got supervision. Oh, like so. See how professional that was? Now that's your sandwich. Now what I need now, which I used last week, we talked about this, a plate. A small plate should do. And I will pop that on there. Now that, my friends, is a cheese sandwich. I hope that's been useful. Thanks for listening. Now next week, I'm going to be making mashed potatoes. Or as in layman's terms, smash. Yes, smash. So take care. Bye for now.